what was written in the early 1970s, when the shadow of the troubles in the north of Ireland was over everybody in Ireland, but especially over people from the north itself. But the north that I thought about in the book called North was the north of the Vikings, the Norsemen, of the Germani, they were called by the Romans, the north of Europe. And so I read a couple of three poems that come out of that moment and that combination of images. North. I return to a long strand, the hammered curve of a bay, and found only the secular powers of the Atlantic thundering. I face the unmagical invitations of Iceland, the pathetic colonies of Greenland. And suddenly, those fabulous raiders, those lying in Orkney and Dublin, measured against their long swords rusting, those in the solid belly of stone ships, those hacked and glinting in the gravel of thawed streams, were ocean-deafened voices warning me, lifted again in violence and epiphany. The long ship's swimming tongue was buoyant with hindsight. It said Thor's hammer swung to geography and trade, thick-witted couplings and revenges, the hatreds and behindbacks of the Althing, lies and women, exhaustions nominated peace, memory incubating the spilled blood. It said, lie down in the word hoard, borrow the coil and dream of your furrowed brain, compose in darkness, expect aurora borealis in the long foray, but no cascade of light. Keep your eye clear of the bleb of the icicle, trust the feel of what nubbed treasure